Grant us the grace, O Lord, we pray, joyfully to be present at the festivity of Our Lady's Assumption, the words of the collect of today's Mass, of the Vigil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. It is not yet Our Lady's Assumption. Today is the Vigil, or the great day of preparation. The purple vestments indicate the necessity of some penance on our part. While we here at church are busy with so many things to think of, to prepare for Our Lady's greatest festival tomorrow, the holy day of her Assumption into heaven, keep us in your prayers that all may go well. We have a special intention for a sick man, as well as several other special intentions to recommend first to Our Lady and then to Saint Anthony this morning. After the last gospel, we'll pause for a moment to say the opening prayer for the novena we pray each year for the Assumption, and then after that we'll begin the hymn Salve Antoni, to begin the Saint Anthony devotion. You know that Saint Anthony is an excellent saint to usher us in to a beautiful celebration of Our Lady's Assumption tomorrow, because even as a child he learned from his mother a very great love for our Blessed Mother. His mother's name was Maria Teresa, and he recalls, as a little child, being taken into the chapel of Our Lady in the cathedral, there where he was growing up in the city of Lisbon, the capital of Portugal. The cathedral was dedicated to the Blessed Mother, and the biographer says of him that he felt the power of her intercession, and all his life he had recourse to her protection and her help in all needs and difficulties. And with her assistance, he was able to preserve unsullied in body and soul till his glorious death the shining white garment of a child of God. He learned early on, as a child then, a strong devotion to Our Blessed Mother, and that he never gave up. Nor did Our Blessed Mother, for her part, ever give up on Saint Anthony. To recall that wonderful miracle that she worked, like the Curé of Ars, Saint Anthony was destined to convert many souls, to save them from hell, through a strong devotion to Our Lady. And because of that, Saint Anthony was very roundly hated by the devil. Remember how Saint Anthony was attacked, as the Curé was, by the devil at night when he was in bed, trying to get a little rest. One biographer expresses it: the exhausted Anthony one night gave in to the restoring arms of sleep. Then suddenly, Satan leapt upon him and attempted to strangle him. Invoking the name of the Glorious Virgin, remember that was his favorite hymn, the hymn that begins, O Gloriosa Virginum, and he would pray that very often, and those were almost his last words, he sang them just before he died. So he invoked Our Lady, first of all, under her title, Glorious Virgin. Then he made the sign of the cross on his forehead, and by doing that, he forced the devil to loosen the grip that he had around his neck. Victorious, Anthony opened his eyes to look on the devil running away out of his cell. And then his cell was bathed in light, just as it would be later on when Our Lady would appear and put the child Jesus into his arms as he was studying and praying one night. Saint Anthony had a great devotion to Our Lady, and you might say that Saint Our Lady had in turn a great devotion to Saint Anthony. Let us ask our Saint Anthony today, as we prepare for Our Lady's greatest festival, to find, in case we've lost it, a great devotion and a great confidence in Our Blessed Mother. Let's resolve our own intentions of daily and regular devotion and devotional practices in her honor. And if we've lost anything in our fervor, let us ask Saint Anthony, he's in charge of lost things, to be able to find it again in the arms and by the protection of Our Lady, the most glorious of virgins. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.